I can't remember what we covered last. I think we're going over the test today, right? Does that sound about right? Homework questions? Okay. Lord, I can't even remember.
Because we never went over the ones from chapter
4. 4? Okay.
Yes.
I hope I didn't go over them in the other class. If I did, you'll have to watch the videos. Okay. No, I guess I didn't. All right, so let's go over them. I went ahead and assigned the test. So when you pull it up, you'll see a date for the test as well as the homework. This is 4.1177. 4.1177. Okay, so they give you a table. Now remember, you can do this on your calculator, you can do it on StatCrunch, or you can do it on Excel. I don't really care what the homework questions ask. All I ask on the test is that you can graph the chart plot, or whatever you call it, scatter plot, that you can do the line of best fit with technology, and you can tell me what R is. Okay? So with that being said, let's look at data set. I'm going to see if StatCrunch is working today. Looks like it is. And there's your numbers. So I'll let you write those down. And you can do a scatter plot. X, Y, and compute. There's your scatter plot. I don't know if this will do. I'm not up on StatCrunch, so I don't know if it will put the regression line in there. Let me see if you can. Regression, simple linear, select X, select Y. Let me do some reading here. Okay. And compute. And there is your slope, 2.5. and your intercept. So is Y is equal to 2.5X minus 1.7. There's your R. Correlation coefficient is 0.9587. And we're going to do it on Excel also. So that way you can see, okay, there it is right there. See, I'm not a StatCrunch person. There it is. Of course, it's written Bass-Ackards. And, of course, I think they do that because they do everything Bass-Ackards and statistics, I guess, to make them look important. I don't know. I don't know why they do it. For how many years have you been writing Y is equal to MX plus B? For at least, what, 3 years? Pre-algebra, algebra 1, algebra 2, and then you get statistics. Oh, we're going to turn it around. So, anyway, your R is 0.9587, and your Y is equal to 2.5X minus 1.7. Now let's do it on Excel. So you take that same data, and you open it up on Excel. Highlight it. Go to Insert. Scatter plot, right click on one of the points, add trend line, display equation in R, And of course, R is not here. You have to take the square root of 0.9191, which should be what we had a while ago. What was it, 9579? So 2.5x minus 1.7 over, and 0.9579. So let's go back to the question. Yes?
Would you mind demonstrating on the calculator?
Yeah, be glad to. So let's go to the handy dandy calculator. And I got to pull it up over here because they don't have it on the menu because, I can't say nothing bad about Tri-County Tech anymore. I presented at the conference Saturday, and nobody came to the conference. Nobody came to the presentation. So, which didn't bother me at all. I didn't care. So I kind of predicted. I said, nobody's going to come to it. I said, because it's technology. So my boss came and other people at Tri-County Tech came to watch the presentation. And I asked my boss, I said, why didn't anybody come? She went, she didn't want to tell me. I said, why? Why won't you tell me? She asked there's five people on the committee that does the conference. There's one from Midlands Tech, which is in Columbia, one from Trident Tech, which is in Charleston, and three from other community colleges in Spartanburg, Greenville, I don't know which ones. She said that two of them said they didn't have anybody at their college that could teach it. The other three said their IT department wouldn't support it. So I can't say anything bad about Tri-County Tech anymore because there's five colleges in the state that bust rocks together, I guess, for their chalk. I don't know, but I can't say anything bad about Tri-County Tech when there's five other colleges that don't even know how to support what we're doing down in AC-137 and streaming out to other campuses. So I'm not going to say a word about Tri-County Tech anymore because I'm very happy to be here. Because I could be at one of those colleges busting rocks together for chalk. That's a joke, but anyway. All right.
You're joking. We know you're not
going to
stop talking about
it. No, I'm not going to say a word. Nope. Anyway, I thought y'all would get a kick out of that. All right, let me pull up the handy dandy. I'm going to have to just hold on a second. I'm going to have to bring this. Y'all just have to bear with me a second. There we go. All right. Unfortunately, you can't transfer it to the TI, so you're going to have to type them in. So go to Stat, Edit, just hit Enter, and now type them in. 24667. 24667. And then type in the Ys. 4, 8, 12, 12, 18. 4, 8, 12, 12, 18. And you know what was so sad? One of those colleges was the colleges in our state capital, Columbia, Midlands. That's pretty sad. Okay, there's our points. So now go ahead. They put freeze on it, deep freeze on these computers, so whenever I exit out of something, it erases everything I did. So I'm going to have to go in and turn on the display again. So second, catalog, D, and I'm going to turn the display on so I can get my R. I meant diagnostic, I'm sorry. Diagnostic on. You've already set yours if you left it, if you hadn't changed it since the last time we did it. And that lets the R show up on your screen. All right, so Stat, calculate linear regression. Enter. L1, L2 should be defaulted, so you don't have to type in anything. And calculate. There you go. Y is equal to negative, 2.5 X minus 1.7, and your R value is negative, is 0.9587. Now, to graph it, you go to stat, second, Y is equal, hit enter so you can get into number one, hit enter again to turn the graph on, and go, it's already defaulted to scatter plot, so now all you have to hit is graph. Now you may not be able to see it, so you hit zoom, and I can't remember, zoom statistic is what number? Thank you. 9. And now you type in Y is equal, and is it 2.5 X minus 1.7? Y'all help me out. Appreciate the one person communicating. Thank you. And hit graph. Look at there. It's a miracle. And that's all I care about you being able to do on 4.1 or 4.2. The only other thing is make sure you know what correlation, causality, and slope. Make sure you can do that. That's it out of 4.1 and 4.2. But anyway, let's go ahead and I think they asked you to relate this to their table. And if it's higher or lower, I can't remember which one it is. I don't even teach that. But anyway, the correlation coefficient, what was it, 0.9879, or what was it?
Comes out to be
0.959, thank you. And there it is. And there's the question it asks you. You got to compare it. How many we got? How many dots? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Is there 5 dots? So you got to go here. You got to go to 5. And ours is higher. So the correlation is higher than the critical value. And that's just getting you ready for chapter 7, which we'll get there eventually. So our value is higher than their critical value. So however you put that in here, because the correlation coefficient is positive and the absolute value of the correlation coefficient, I don't know, is point what, 95, or is that, I don't know what they're asking here.
It's the same thing.
Greater, okay, 0.959?
Yeah.
Thank you. It's greater than the critical value data set, 0.8578, thank you. 0.878, to me this is just worthless. Not until we get to chapter 7, I mean, a positive linear coefficient, I guess that's it. Let me move this out of the way. Yeah. There you go. So for your homework, you have to do this last little part here, and I'm concerned about everything above it. Okay? So that's that. And we'll do another one here in just a second on the calculator if you need extra help. That's 4.117. Let's see if it's different. So you can do it on your calculator. Let's see if it's a little bit different. Yeah, it's a little bit different. So do that one. I'll put it on the Excel spreadsheet for you so you can see it. Trying to sneeze. That means I got the coronavirus. I'm going to be dead tomorrow.
Did you hear it was in Greenville?
Of course it is. Let me guess. They found a bird with it, or they found a mouse that has it, or some person that just moved from California has it. I gave it a week. It would be in Greenville. Now, is it a made-up person or is it a person?
I don't know. I just heard.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. I've never seen a. I'm shut up, Hubert. Just shut up. wannabe little town. So I'm going to give y'all a second or two, give y'all a minute to get it all in your calculator.
After we put in the numbers, we hit start and then what did we go to?
Calculate to get your information. And then I want you to graph the scatter plot, and I want you to graph the number line, I mean the regression line on the scatter plot. And if you can't do that, then that means you're a failure. But don't worry, because you don't need to improve yourself, because Bernie will take care of you. Steyer dropped out. The reptilian, he said he dropped out. He looked like a daggum reptile, didn't he? Yeah. I don't even know her name. It's going to be Bernie and Biden. And Biden is waiting on Super Thursday.
Well, it's Super Tuesday.
I know, but he said Super Thursday. Oh, okay. And he also said he was running for Senate. Yeah, go ahead and press that button. I need some coffee. Set off nuclear codes. They gonna cheat Bernie out of it. You wait and see what I tell you. He's gonna have those delegates. They gonna cheat him out of it. I hate that, because you gotta give the man a little bit of credit. He does have a following. He has a revolution behind him. But what they gonna do? They gonna steal it from him. And it's the Russians' fault. Y'all got it? Well, I'm going to go ahead and do it here so y'all can check your handy-dandy calculator and see if y'all got it right. And then we'll do it on the calculator. And after that, y'all should be able to do this problem. Add trend line. Display. Hopefully that's what y'all got. Y'all get it? Now let's use the handy dandy calculator. Stat. Edit. 2, 4, 6, 6, 7, and 4, 8, 11. God, they didn't change the numbers very much, did they? 14 and 18. Now go to stat. Calculate, linear regression, and calculate. There you go. 1.8125, 2.56, and R is 0.9517. Now let's take our handy dandy second. Stat plot, which is Y is equal on. It's already on scatter plot right there. So all you got to do is hit graph. And that's not the regression line, because I got to type it in. The regression line is 2.5625 X minus 1.8125. And graph. There you go. So I'm questioning. Y'all never done that on your calculator before? In high school? Wow. I thought y'all like twirled them things on your fingers like a basketball in high school. They don't do that anymore. Well, that's a good thing. You learned how to do it. Wow. Maybe there's hope. All right, so that's two good homework questions. If you can do those two questions, you can handle pretty much 4.1 and 4.2. All right, let's go to the next question. That's that one, delete. 17, 19. This is 19/8. I don't know if this one's coming from this class. Yeah, it's coming from this class. Same type question. I'm going to just keep on going if y'all don't mind. So that's 19. I'm going to keep on going. 27/10. Okay. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put it in Excel. I don't know what they're going to ask, but we're going to put it in Excel. There it is. I'm going to highlight it. I'm going to go ahead and let you write them down, put them in your calculator, make it a little bit bigger for you. There you go. This is how tall you are. You got a big head or something like that, isn't it? So if you're 3 foot tall, got a big head, that means you don't fit in with the mold, evidently. Insert. So it looks like to me, as the height increases, so does the what? Dang old big head syndrome. So, oh yeah, that's right. Y'all don't make fun of people. Y'all don't make fun of each other anymore, do you? In high school, we used to do that all the time. Now, I guess you'd call it bullying, right? There you go. Of course, y'all don't call it joning anymore, do you? What do y'all call it? That's what we called it, joning on each other. Y'all don't even do that anymore, do you? Huh? It's called dogging. Is that what it is? Well, what is it? It's still called joning? Wow.
I've heard people call it.
That's interesting. Yeah, the football players are bad about that. We used to do it all the time. To each other. We wouldn't do it to people, you know, like we would do it to each other. Okay, I'll shut up. There you go. So somebody tell me what R is, 0.8403. Take the square root. What is R?
0.934.
So you still got a good correlation. Anything above 0.9 is very, very what? Strong. Okay, anybody got any questions on this one? I have no idea what the homework question asked. It probably asked what's the address of these people. I don't know what it asked. Probably asked something really lame. So write down that information so we can go back to the question and try to figure out what they're asking. I know that's awful to say, but sometimes I believe Philadelphia lawyers wrote these questions and these homework questions because you can't understand what they're asking. So don't feel pregnant. Everybody gets confused about the questions. All right, y'all got it written down? All right, let's look at the question. Well, let's look and see what the graph looks like. Okay, we got one sticking up here. All right, so we need to find one that looks. Okay, let's see. What do they ask? If the pediatrician wants to use height to predict head circumference, determine which variable is the explanatory variable and which is the response variable. Yes, sir.
Oh, I'm sorry, I was yawning.
That's all right.
How do you get your R on your calculator again? You gotta turn on.
Go to second and go down to catalog down at the bottom. and find diagnostic and turn it on. Okay, the response variable is pretty much what's responding. So in this case, wants to determine the relationship may exist between a child's height and head circumference. All right? So the head circumference is like the secondary, right? What's the primary? The height. So look at it like that. Which came first, the chicken or the egg? In this case, what are you looking at first? You're looking at the height. Then you're looking at the what? The head circumference. So therefore, the primary is the height. The secondary is the what? Head circumference. So therefore, turn it to statistician's terms. The explanatory, or whatever, how you ever pronounce it, is the height. And the response, which is the secondary, that's your head circumference. So if you're gonna grow up to be very tall, you're gonna have a big ass head. That's pretty much what it means. All right. So C is there. I used to have a good friend. We played side by side together in football. He passed away a few years ago, and that was his favorite. He talked about everybody having a big head. All right. So there is R, 0.917. Now, I don't know what they're going to ask now. Yes, there is a linear relationship, and it is very strong. Didn't we come up with 0.917? Anything above anything really above 0.8 is very strong. All right? So D is the answer there. And I don't know. Here's their critical values. So how many we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there's the critical value. That's the measuring stick. 0.707. So we do have a very strong correlation because our factor is above what they predict. Everybody see that? So I don't know what they're going to ask. Oh, now this is ridiculous. Convert the data to centimeters. Okay, you're going to have to find your inches to centimeters and convert. But what they're trying to show you here is they're trying to show you that if you convert to miles, is it going to matter? The data doesn't change just because you convert it. Write that down. The data does not change because you convert it. You can convert it to feet if you wanted to instead of inches. It still would be the same data. You say tomato, I say tomato. It doesn't matter whether you have inches or where they want you to change it to, centimeters. So how do you do that? Well, you go to Google and you say, what? 1 inch is equal to what? This is the quickest way to do it. 1 inch equals what? Centimeter. And there's your conversion, so write that down. Now, you can get you a table. You can go to unit conversion table. Is everybody listening? You can go to unit conversion table if you like to keep up with stuff like this, and you can go to images and dang old knock yourself out right there. Dang old index card. Well, I don't know why it's doing that, but let's go to this one. There you go. And you can print that out and put it on the index card. Of course, now it's I hate them. There. So let's look for 1 inch. No yawning in class. And where is length? There we go. Okay, this is centimeters. Okay, I thought they would have unit conversions. It's supposed to be from standard. Hold on, let me turn it around. I'm trying to show y'all how to do something here. Unit conversion, standard picture. Okay, and you can find you one. Here's one. 1 inch is equal to 2.5 centimeters. So you can carry one of these index cards around, tape this to an index card and carry it around, or you could just Google it and say, okay, 2.5, and multiply all your inches times 2.5, and you're going to see that nothing happens. Okay? So whoever sent this question in, you're going to take your calculator. Well, let's go. Did I pull this up on? Yeah. Okay, I'm going to show you a trick I learned in war. Right here. You take this, and you go equals this number times what? 2.54, Hubert. That's right, class. And just copy that down. I don't know how many. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So one, let's go ahead and do this one too. Equals this number times 2.54. Everybody with me? And now just copy that down 8 times. And you feel good about yourself. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Boom. Now, watch this. Take that same thing. Insert. What happened? Not a damn thing. Why? Because you didn't do anything. You didn't change anything. You just multiplied it times. Let me ask you a question. If you got a recipe that makes a dozen cookies, everybody with me? And you double it, is the cookies going to be the same? Yeah. What?
If you do it correctly.
Yeah, well, that's true. If you do it correctly. Yeah, the cookies will be the same, except there'll be just more of them. All right, let's finish this up. I'm going to add the, and what should happen? It should be the same thing. This is one of those standardized test questions, kind of like, what is the probability of rolling a 7 on a die?
0.
What is the probability of drawing one card and picking a heart and a king? 0. Because you can't pick two cards on one draw. Remember reading the question? You got to listen. This same thing. They're going to ask you this on a standardized test and say, what happens if you convert to miles? Nothing. Nothing happens. What was our square factor on the first one? 0.8403, wasn't it? Look at there. If you change somebody's height from 6 foot to 124 centimeters or whatever, if you use that conversion, does the person grow any or shrink? No. So you'd be surprised on how many people do that conversion and they don't understand why they're doing it. They're trying to show you that even if you convert from, if the data doesn't change, and you should feel good about yourself. Why y'all are doing this self-improvement anyway. There's no need. 4.1 delete. 4.2. 13/5. The whole problem. All right. First thing I'm going to do is okay. The least squares regression, they give you the least square. There's the line. Where Y is the medium income and X is the percentage of 25-year-olds or older with a bachelor's degree in the region. The scatter diagrams indicate linear regression between the two variables. Correlation is 0.7717. A through D. Predict the median income of a region of which 30% blah, blah, blah. So X is what? 30%? So what do we do? Plug and what? Plug and chug. Do that.
to take your handy dandy virtual pen, and I'm not going to punch it in. I'm going to let y'all punch it in. Y is equal to 7, okay, 714.2 parentheses plus 14, is that a comma? 14 point, is that 14 point? I can't see if it's a comma or not.
I think it's a comma.
It's a comma.
It's a comma. Yes, 14.824 and 0.3 goes right there. Somebody work that out and tell me what you get. Let's see, 10% would be 71. 71 times 3 is 213. 213 be 15,000, a little over 15,000. What would it be? $15,038.26. So 15038. This is just predictions, plug and chug. So type in round to the nearest dollar. So that's going to be 15,038. Man, I got it wrong.
I think we're supposed to use 30 instead of 0.3.
Well, then they need to specify that. All right, plug in 30. I'm sorry.
36,250.
Okay, 36 what?
36,250.
36,250. That. Okay, my bad. So type that in as a 30. That's probably why a person had a question. So type 30 instead of 0.3. I suck on that one. There we go. All right, next question. In a particular region, 29.2% of the adults and older have at least a bachelor's degree. The median income is 39, blah, blah, blah. Is the blah, blah, blah. Is this income higher than what you would expect? Why? Well, you need to plug in 29.2. So go ahead and plug in 29.2. What do you get? Somebody do that. So Y is equal to 714.2 times 29.2 plus 14,824. And somebody tell me, round that to the nearest dollar. $35,600 and what?
79.
So it's higher or lower? Lower. I guess that's what they're going to ask. I don't know. This is lower, I guess, lower than expected. Okay, higher. I'm trying to see which way they're going with this. Because the expected income is $35,679. You can see how you could get twisted here. I don't know. I hope I'm reading it right. Yeah, I did. It's not a good test question. It's too vague. Y'all might like it. I don't know. Interpret the slope. Select the correct choice below and fill in the answer block to complete your choice. The slope is 714. So for every, that's the rate of change, so 714, I'm looking to see what they're asking here. For medium income, the percent bachelor's is, for every percent increase in adults have at least bachelor's degree, that's a possibility. For every dollar increase, that's a possibility. I'd say it's either B or C. I'm looking to see. I think it's for every dollar increase, probably. But I don't think the 7.14 is, it's not 714. 714.2. Yeah, so that's change in Y over the change in X. So you have to actually find 2 points. So let's see what they get. Isn't that what I answered? Oh, it's the one above it. Okay. All right, for every percent increase. I told you it was B or C. Explain why it does not make sense to interpret the y-intercept choosing the correct answer below. Well, the y-intercept is 14.8, but that's saying that you what? That's at the bachelor's percentage, that's 15%. I don't know if it's going to zero or not, but you know, usually when you have the y-intercept, what is x? Zero. So that's at 0%. You see what I'm saying? So that's probably why you're not using the y-intercept, because that's at 0% people are representative. So which one says that? Which one of these says zero is not reasonable? Outside the scope, you could do that. It's not this. Why isn't it C and D? Somebody's supposed to be answering me. Why isn't it C or D? Y value cannot be zero. It's what? It's 14.824. So it's got to be A or B, okay? And you could actually say either one, but I would say outside the scope of the model because that sounds more important. See? Is does not make sense. Could you use that as an answer? Yeah, because are you ever gonna have zero representation? No. You're not going to have zero representation. There's always going to be somebody to represent a certain part of an income. Okay? So that's the answer there. Please tell me that's it for this question. This sucks. So whoever sent that one, you had a reason to send it. It sucked. Delete. Mrs. 15 was probably the same type question. Is there a relationship between age difference between husbands and wives in a percent of country that is literate? Is there a relationship between age difference between husbands/wives and the percent of a country that is literate? You have to read into that a little bit. Researchers found the least square regression between age difference of husband and wife, age minus husband's age minus the wife's age, Y, and literacy rate is Y is equal to -0.05, blah, 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 blah. The model applied for ages of 23 to 100, complete parts A through E. Oh, good gracious. Oh, interpret the slope, select the correct. What's the slope telling you? Negative correlation. So I don't know. For every unit increase, you're going to have a decrease. For every unit increase, I would say age difference, the literacy rate fails by 0.0563, I guess that's what they're asking. Okay. I don't know what they're asking for here. Is that not what I... Okay, did I do it Bass-Ackards? Yeah, I did it Bass-Ackards. The literacy rate falls for the age difference or something like that. Does it make sense to interpret the y-intercept? Well, look at the y-intercept. You're talking about 7.3 at zero. Okay? Now, zero is what? I mean, x is the what? The age, right? Yeah. So at zero, are you going to be married? At zero, when your day you're born, are you going to be married? Okay, so somebody needs to decipher which one it says that. Does it make sense or it's impossible? Whichever one you want to say, I don't know. Outside the scope. That sounds a whole lot more important, doesn't it? Here's another one. Okay, but the y value can't be zero, so it has to be this one. Predict the age difference between husband and wife in a country where the literacy rate is 33. Go ahead and do that one. Plug and what? Chug. Plug and chug. So, predict the age difference. So that's going to be y is equal to negative 0.0563. 33 plus 7.3. So somebody crank that out for me. It says round to one decimal place. Well, 10% would be 3.3. So 5% would be half of that, which is 1.7. Dang old six something. What is it? I might be way off on that one. I was thinking around six. What is it? Okay, I'll just wait. 5.4. What? 5.4. So the difference in age is going to be around 5.5 years. Is this very important for y'all's education? No. Who cares? But anyway, 5.4. Next. These questions irritate me. Would it make sense to use this model to predict the age difference between husband and wife in a country where the literacy rate is 18%? Yes or no? I don't see why it wouldn't. I don't know, 18%. Well, it is outside the scope. So, I don't know. Let's see what it says. Let me erase this. Anybody got a thought? It makes sense because the Y value of 18 is within the realm of possibilities. That's true because it's above 7.3. So, makes sense because the X value of 18, the X value is not 18. That's isn't that the literacy rate? Literacy rate is Y. The age is, no, that's not right. So, I would say A, but I'm probably wrong. Yep. So, that means it's no. So, Y value of 18 is outside the scope. I don't know how they come up with that. No, I suck. C. Or is it D? It does not make sense because an X value of 18 is outside the scope of the model. Right there. Okay. 18 is lower than 23. My bad on that one. How many more parts? So we go to Z on this one. The literacy rate in a country is 99% the literacy rate is 99%, and the age difference between husband and wives is 2 years. Is this age difference above or below the average of an age difference countries whose literacy rate is 99? So plug in 99. Somebody plug in 99 and round to one decimal place. What'd you get? I'm sorry, what?
1.7.
So it's lower, okay? 1.7. So it'd be below at 1.7. Did everybody get 1.7? Okay, whatever. It's above 1.7. Good golly molly. Whatever. Thank God that's over. These are just very tedious questions. Let's go to the next. Well, let's see, 4.215, 4.221. I can see why y'all sending these questions. They suck. An engineer wants to determine how the weight of a gas-powered car affects the mileage. Well, we all know how that happens. As the weight of a car goes up, what does the gas mileage do? Goes down. So you already know that. The accompanying data represents the weights of various domestic cars and their miles per gallon in the city for the most recent car model. There you go. So we're going to take this over to the Excel spreadsheet and we're going to do what's warranted. Oh, there's the elevator music.
Hi there. It's currently 9:05 a.m. With a current temperature of 53 degrees Fahrenheit, today's high is 67 degrees Fahrenheit, and the low is 49 degrees Fahrenheit. Looks like it'll be a cloudy day.
Cloudy day.
Now,
it's now the news. Trump is a racist, and we're all going to die. What? Yeah, she's very soothing. We're all going to die in 12. No, we're all going to die before 12 years, because the coronavirus is going to kill us all. But you got to be over 90 years old for it to kill you. But they hadn't told you that yet. Just like the flu. But anything to bring down the economy. So anyway, I'll shut up. Data. Insert. Okay, let's see what kind of correlation we got here. There's your R. Somebody tell me what R is. 0.8283 raised to the 1/2 power. Point 0.91. Strong correlation, yes or no? Yes. So that means if you buy a 4,500-pound car, what are you going to get? Somebody plug in 4,500 pounds. Dang old, I'm going to try to estimate. Take my handy dandy straight edge. Dang old. Put it right here. Looks like about 12 miles to the gallon. Yeah, about 12, 11.8, something like that. Somebody crank it out and tell me what you get at 4,500. I said 12 or 11.8. What do you get? Boy, y'all are not on the calculator drill team, are you? That's a good thing. I'm very happy. As long as you ain't twirling it around like a basketball, that's a good thing. But somebody should have an answer by now. I'm like, what? I said 11.8 or 12. It's a miracle. No, I just drew a line. Okay? So, I don't know. They're going to ask you, what kind of car is this blue dot right here? But I don't know. But they're going to ask you that. So, I don't know. I don't know what they're going to ask you. Probably who's driving this car right here. Aren't you glad that I really don't care about those type problems? I could. You want me to put them on test? I will. Okay. I figure I get some kind of reaction out of you. Anyway, let's see. I have no idea what they're going to ask, but you see that you have a negative correlation. Interpret the slope and y-intercept. Okay, we're going to stop there. I'm not going to. Let's just check answer and see. I'm going to go ahead and finish this problem. For every pound added to the weight of the car, the gas mileage is decreased 0.0. That's the slope. That's the rate of what? Rate of change. Okay? And a certain gas-powered car weighs 3,500 pounds and gets 18 miles per gallon. Is the miles per gallon of this car above or below? Well, let's go look at 3,500. 3,500. So let's take our handy-dandy straight line maker. And 3,500, or somebody plug it in. Okay, plug it in, because 18 is what you get when you use straight line. So plug in 3,500, what do you get? Whichever you, it says, is the miles per gallon of this car above average? So I would say it's above. No, it's below because it's 18. You got to read these questions two or three times. It should be below. I can't believe I got one right. Would it be reasonable to use the least square regression line to predict the miles of a hybrid or electric car? Would you compare apples to oranges? Now, I would like to know how much gasoline or diesel or coal or natural gas it takes to generate the power to charge the battery for the electric car. Maybe it's a windmill. Anyway, big no. Why? Because you can't compare apples to what? Oranges. Now, that ain't a bad question, okay? This one's not a bad question because it's applicable to something you relate to versus whether your brother married your sister and they're 18 years old or different or whatever, okay? So, all right, let's shut her down. Let's go ahead and cut that one out. That's 4.221. All right, we only got a few left. We'll get those Thursday. Y'all can go ahead and start on your test. If you don't want to, you can wait. And I think the test, the homework cuts off Thursday. So, we're still good. All right, let me shut off the recorder. And let me take the roll. And Johnson, Hamby, and Adams is here.